Welcome back to the last day of our exploration of African-American culture presented by TheReEducation.blog. Today, we are going to start our exploration of art. If you haven't caught up on day one and day two, don't worry. I've got you covered. Check the links below. But since you're here, let's talk about art. Now, art and culture are so synonymous that there isn't even a need for an explanation. However, the topic of art is so broad that I couldn't begin to cover it all. It's so many directions that I can go with this topic, but because I was watching Ma Rainey's Black Bottom while trying to find my muse, we're going to look at music. So stay tuned and see if you like what you hear. I won't get into too many of the details of the movie because I'm no movie critic, and I don't want to give the movie away in case you want to experience it for yourself. So let's just start with the blues. Ma Rainey is known as the mother of blues, but that is a little known fact to many, or at least to me. Blues music originated where everything else we have been talking about originated, on the other side of the transatlantic slave trade in the southern United States. The origin of the blues are not that well known or documented, and is steeped in a bit of folklore. There is actually a documentary on Netflix chronicling the life of the mysterious blues legend Robert Johnson called Devil at the Crossroads that really does a good job of depicting this mystique. Now, the blues was considered the devil's music, mainly because of its association with the artist. Seeing as how the originators of the blues music were descendants of slaves, the art form itself was demonized and not seen as respectable. From what we know, the blues originated in the 1800s in the southern United States and was a cross between old Negro spirituals, chants, and ballads unique to the African-American community. The blues is unique in that it has an obvious overtone of sadness created by scales that were stylized to create chords not heard in traditional harmonies. Flattened thirds and pitches heard between notes, called blue notes, give the blues that distinguishable sound. Now that was for my music nerds. Outside of the technical aspect, the blues was foundational in the formation of American music. From the blues, you had the formation of ragtime, jazz, R&B, and rock and roll. Some of the most famous rock and roll artists got their inspiration from black artists. According to a certain swath of music historians, they weren't really stealing so much as covering. So essentially, Elvis Presley did a cover of Big Mama Thornton's You Ain't Nothing But a Hound Dog, but neglected to divvy up the royalties accordingly. And even though we love a good Beach Boys bop, Surfing in the USA was a complete copy and paste of Chuck Berry's Sweet Little 16. Oh yeah, and the Beatles, they were also inspired by the rock and roll stylings of Chuck Berry.
You ain't nothing but a hound dog, been snooping round my door. You ain't nothing but a hound dog.
You ain't nothing but a hound dog, girl. You're crying all the time. You ain't nothing but a hound dog, crying all the time.
Billy Rocket in Boston and Pittsburgh, PA, deep in the heart of Texas and round the Frisco Bay.
Countless black artists were quintessential to the formation of American and international music. Unfortunately, they are often left out of the story. Too many of the forefathers and foremothers died broke and nameless and have had to receive their flowers posthumously for their contributions to the American sound. Ma Rainey herself was inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame nearly 50 years after her death. Ma Rainey's Black Bottom sets out to introduce an unsung figure of the most foundational genre of music to ever exist in America. In doing so, it highlights an all too familiar reality of the exploitation of black voices for mainstream consumption with little to no recognition. Check out Ma Rainey's Black Bottom and Ma Rainey's Black Bottom, A Legacy Brought to Screen, now streaming on Netflix. This is not sponsored content. Thank you so much for showing up and tuning in. If you want to learn more, you can check out the links below. And of course, stay tuned for this week's blog post, where I'll be sharing some more interesting musical facts. As always, please feel free to share your thoughts and keep the conversation going. Until next time, peace.